Hey guys, so here I am at Fort 1410 Gantry. It looks like it's about to pour down rain on me, so I'm going to try to get through the outside pretty quickly. So sorry if I'm a little speedy. Very pretty. And this is what your neighborhood looks like, your little cul-de-sac down here. Lovely. Let's walk around the exterior really fast while it's not raining. They are moving. They're in the process of packing up. The agent warned me that it may not be as show ready as it is in the pictures, but because they are already packing up and moving. So this is your neighbors beside you, their backyard. I think that the carrier unit is to the mini split. They may have that sunroom conditioned with a mini split. This is what's in the back, this cute little pond. Oops, little fishy. It's so pretty. Look at this cute thing. Hey. It's a beautiful tree. They do have a dog. I believe this grill is staying. That's nice. This is the back exterior. Beautiful. Really nicely done. Walk around the side.
Good, how are you doing?
Really pretty. Okay, let's go inside and take a look. Okay, here we go. Beautiful. As I mentioned, they are in the process of moving out, so it's not as staged or as, doesn't have the furniture, it's perfectly placed, but gives you a good idea of the space. I love these floors. I love the wide plank and the variations. Very pretty. Here we have an office area. It's nice and bright. Love the ceiling. This is a great space. Got the hall closet right here, coat closet. Nice wide, plenty of room right here in this walking area. The coffered ceilings are really pretty. Lovely built-ins. Gas fireplace. We have propane here mostly. There are a few neighborhoods that are natural gas. Nice, huge kitchen. Look at this kitchen. Oh my goodness, it's huge. You got your pantry cabinet here. Oh my gosh, I love these counters. Look how pretty those are. These cabinets look custom. Nothing looks builder grade in this house right now. Very pretty. The crown molding, the window casing, gas stove. Very pretty. KitchenAid appliances. Microwave. Oven. And dishwasher. Another pantry cabinet here. So although this house doesn't have a pantry, it does have those two pantry cabinets. Out into the backyard. Got the little pond view. You have access to the sunroom off the dining room. And here off the living. You You have the telescoping doors there. They have enclosed this to make it conditioned space. It used to just be a screen porch, I'm assuming, or a lanai. Surround sound speakers up there. And you've got these two skylights here. I do not, this may be the conditioning. I've never seen one of those. I guess it's not a mini split, but that is what's conditioning the space when needed. You have access here off the owner's suite as well. So here is a view of this space from this angle. Very pretty. Definitely need some paint touch up, but of course they're moving. Oh, look at this floor. That is tile. That's very unique. I haven't seen that before on the interior of a home. That's very unique. It's pretty. So that goes to the owner's bath. Here is the owner's suite with this tray ceiling with the lighting in the tray. That goes off to the sunroom. They have nice shades, the cordless shades. I like those so much better than blinds. And they're not inexpensive, and they're already in the home. There's plenty of room in here. And then this goes to the walk-in closet. You can see here, definitely need some paint. But nothing too bad. This is a great closet. It's got the wood shelving instead of the ventilated wire shelving. So this is nice. Here, we've got another closet. Definitely need to wipe down. Hi, nice to meet you. And this is the owner's bath. Soaking tub, or jacuzzi tub actually. It does have the jacuzzi jets. Jacuzzi tub, separate his and her vanities. Lovely granite on top, and this is wallpaper. We've got a separate water closet in there, and then you have a linen closet. And a shower. That's a great shower. Actually, let me give you a peek over here. That's neat. You can keep towels in there, and I guess they don't get wet. So this is a very large shower. Let me just hop in here. You've got that shower head with a handheld, and then this rain shower head, I guess.
plenty of space in this shower.
I like it. Okay. Let's head out this way. And head on to the other side of the house. So you've got a second bedroom here. This is a good size bedroom for a secondary bedroom. They do have blinds in here and not the cordless shades. But that's okay. Oh, lovely antique furniture. Decent size closet. And this gives you private access into the bathroom that we're about to go see. Okay, very spacious secondary bath. Ooh, I love the drawers in the vanity. I would much rather have one sink and then have this space here with the drawers like that rather than having the plumbing for the sink taking up that good storage. I think this is a great idea for a secondary bath, just to have the one sink but have this large vanity. I like that a lot. Got tile surround around the tub. This bathroom also has wallpaper in it. And this is the third bedroom. And I'm thinking that closet, I can't really get into it, but that closet is probably a very similar size as the one in the other bedroom. This is a decent sized room. A little bit smaller. Or actually, maybe it's the same size. It may be the same size. This one seems bigger probably because it has the furniture set up in it. You've got a powder room. For guests here, right as you come in through the garage into the laundry room. Got some nice cabinets here and a sink in here. Very nice. Decent sized garage. You do have some storage over here. Which is nice. Boop. That's good to have. The floor is epoxied. There's your pull down to your attic. Shut off this light. And you do have an access door in the garage. Here's your water heater. Looks like there was some leaking up there at some point. I am wondering if Brunswick Forest has natural gas. I'll have to check into that. Maybe they do.
This is a surge protector. It says jacuzzi on it.
Refrigerator in the garage. So, good size garage. Okay. So, that completes the tour. Let me know what you guys think. Just one last look around to make sure. There was some leaking there above that water heater, and there's something going on here too. I don't know if you can see that. It makes me think that maybe there's some water there at some point. Is this dry underneath here? Yeah, pretty dry. I wonder. Maybe it was a roof leak. Okay, guys. I'm gonna get out of here. Let me know what you think.